Hello everyone. Hello guys. This time Mrs. Priyanka Sisodia, Percentile classes के साथ आज मैं फिर आप लोगों के लिए लेके आई हूँ RC 10 का part 3. So in this particular session we are going to talk about economic type of passages and probably this is the most important type of passage that comes in different exams, and because there's always something going on in our economy, so there are passages which are relevant to the topic which are running right now. So the first thing that I would like to include in this particular video is the current topics on which this year's passage can be based on. So there are many things which are going on because we can see that there is demonetization and there is black money. So certain these words are there. So the passage can be there which are based on these particular points. For example, we can have passages based on, like, first thing, demonetization ke upar based koi bhi passage aapko aa sakta hai. Then we can have, like, the most other other topic can be loan waiver. We see that there is one thing that is called NPA, non-profitable assets. So I would like you people to just Google these terms, what these terms are. Demonetization, I guess everyone is well aware about. And then we have loan waiver. Loan waiver is specifically about the farmers. Farmers ka jo loan waivers hota hai. These very good passages can be made on these particular points, and these are relevant. So I guess reading newspaper can very well help you. And there's NPA. NPA is a very huge topic, and it is not going to end. Like, it is this year, and it would be next year as well. And then we have topics like NPA. After NPA, we can have topics like privatization, and then we can have topics based on disinvestment. So I would advise you all that you must just Google all these terms. Disinvestment, what is disinvestment, what is demonetization, so that when the passage based on these topic comes to you, you are familiar with these topics. Okay, so demonetization, we all know what it is, changing currency. And then we have loan waiver. Loan waiver means rebate on loan is provided and the loan is completely waived off. Anyways, it can be. NPA is non-profitable asset. The full form is non-profitable asset. And then what it actually is, there are certain assets, there are certain usually jo jyada jis cheez ke bare mein yahan baat ki jati hai wo loan hi hai. There are certain big loans which are provided to certain business person or business house, and that is not paid back. To aise loan ya aise assets jo hote hain wo kya ban jate hain, non profitable. So these are non profitable assets. Theek, jo ek bad asset bhi, bad loan bhi ban jata hai, wo bhi bol sakte hain apan ko. Theek hai, next point which I am going to include in this topic is important word meaning for economic passages. See, anyone who is not well familiar with RC10, let me tell you one thing. RC10 is a collection of 10 different type of passages. Every week I come with a new type of passage. In that particular video, I provide you one different context, and then different words or jargons related to that context, and one of the passages we solve together. So this is how we are doing. Two sessions we have already completed. If you have not seen it, just go to our YouTube channel Percentile Classes, and then you'll be able to see RC 10 part 1, RC 10 part 2, RC 10 part 1 mein aapko passage mil jayenge. ठीक है, एंड RC 10 पार्ट 2 में भी आपको ऐसा ही एक वीडियो मिलेगा, इन विच आई हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट टू डिफरेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट अर्लियर. एंड इफ यू हैव नॉट सीन दीज टू वीडियोस, जस्ट गो एंड वॉच इट. एंड दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर सीरीज RC 10. और आज की सीरीज में इकोनॉमिक टाइप के पैसेजेस को हम डिस्कस करने वाले हैं. द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इन दिस वीडियो आई हैव बॉट इज करेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक पैसेज. सो दीज आर डिफरेंट करेंट टॉपिक्स दैट on that the passage can be based on. इन सारे टॉपिक्स पे जो पैसेज है वो बेस्ड हो सकता है. सो फर्स्ट थिंग वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑन, नेक्स्ट थिंग इज इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड मीनिंग फॉर इकोनॉमिक पैसेज. लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दैट. So now we have, I have, because in economic context, there are certain words for which the meaning of, according to the context, the meaning completely changes. So in this particular video, we have more such word, and I would just advise you that you just once go through the word, because these all are very important. For example, let's start with the first word that I have, abstinence is the first word. Abstain we all know, and then abstinence means the act of remaining absent from the job even without any compulsive reason is called absenteeism. So the second is livestock, the share of companies which are frequently dealt in stock market. Jo stock market mein bahut frequently deal hoti hai, aise share of company ko hum bolte hain livestock. Then we have like actuary, a person who calculate risk factor for insurance company. ठीक, तो उस person को हम actually बोलते हैं. Then we have appropriation, distribution of money on various heads is appropriation. That we then we have arbitrage, the act of buying at a low price from one market and selling at higher price in another. So just once go through, these are very important words. Then we have ad valorem. Usually in economic passage we see these type of foreign words, so we must be very much once reading these foreign words can lead to better understanding of these passages. So ad valorem means according to value. So according to the value of any asset is called in foreign language it is ad valorem. Then we have anarchy. Anarchy, we know anarchy already is there in political terms as well, but in economic terms it is socio-economic efforts are unrestricted by government. Aisi situation ko hum anarchy bolte hain. Then we have autarky. There are two different words, anarchy and autarky. Autarky is a condition of satisfying one's need internally and without import. It's called autarky. Then we have barter. Barter, we all know, exchange of goods and services. Then we have brain drain. It's a very famous theory. The migration of skill to richer area is called brain drain. Bullion. Bullion is an important word. Bullion basically means gold. Then we have balance of payment. This is very frequently used word. Balance of payment, current account deficit. So ये सारे terms जो हैं इनको एक बार आपको balance of payment तो मैंने यहाँ include कर लिया है. Current account deficit आपको एक बार देख लेना चाहिए. Balance of payment means a statement of debit and credit of a country. किसी भी country का debit और credit का जो statement होता है इसको अपन बोलते हैं balance of payment. Let's come to the next word. Black economy, demonetization के साथ एक और term जो काफी famous हुआ वो है black economy. So black money. So what black money is? Black money is nothing but certain amount which is not accounted in any book. So in your tax it is not accounted and it is not accounted anywhere else. That type of money is called black money. ठीक है, कोई भी unaccounted money which you are not authorized with to have, ऐसे किसी भी money को रखना black और वो possess करना, that is black money. Then we have capitalism. Capitalism is a system of economy where means of production is governed by individual, not by government. So in this particular type, like we have, ये तो बहुत ही frequently used होने वाला word है. बहुत ही ज़्यादा use किया था capitalism and capitalistic. So capitalism is a kind of ideology and capitalistic वो countries जिस ideology को support करती है. Then we have closed economy. An economy that has no external trade to protect its interest. Then we have collusion, mutual cooperation. Then we have blue chip, बहुत important word है ये. Company share which is sold at high premium and is supposed to be the safest is called blue chip. Book value, the value of an asset in company's account. Then we have buffer stock, the stock of commodity used to meet extreme condition in market. तो वो जो holding करके रखते हैं stock का, एक जो अपन extra stock रखते हैं उसी को अपन बोलते हैं buffer stock. Then we have consolidated fund, important word है ये. Fund with the central bank of which government's expenditure is met and in which tax is collected. So that particular fund which is basically a collection of your taxes and from which the government's expenditure are made up is called consolidated fund. let's come to the next part of vocab. Then we have demography. Bahut hi important word hai demography. This is nothing but study of population. So, jo bhi population hai, jo people wahan rehte hain, unki study ko hum demography bolte hain. Then we have again, I told you disinvestment. Selling a part of share of government owned organization to private organization. So this is kind of privatization. Okay? So government invest a particular share in a particular department, and then this investment is nothing but getting back, like wo share sale karke kisi bhi private entity ko, getting back that amount is called disinvestment. That then we have econometric. Making economic prediction using mathematics is called econometric. Then we have ergonomics, the science of creating such an environment as the worker is encouraged to produce his optimum. Take aise science ko apan bolte hai ergonomics, which is right now very much like bahut sari countries aisi hain jo isko bahut zyada use karti hain productivity ko enhance karne ke liye. Then we have exchequer. Exchequer is nothing but treasury, forex is the short form of foreign exchange. Then we have hedging. Hedging is an important word. Hedging means the technique used to protect business from fluctuation in price of input. For example, you are running a business and you from certain input you provide an output, a product you made, and if that input price is fluctuating, you need not to fluctuate your output cost. So you need to go for hedging so that the output's cost does not fluctuate as the input cost fluctuate. Then we have hoarding. We have already talked about amassing of money secretly. Then we have insolvent, means bankrupt. Laissez-faire is ideology or a condition in which government is least involved in economic affairs. Then we have portfolio, monetary asset held by a firm in an individual or an individual is called portfolio. Then we have sack. Sack is removal of employees from some ground. Then we have speculation, buying or selling with the profit motive when the price is favorable. Stagflation is an important word. Deflation is a phase of recession, inflation, and growing unemployment. Windfall, loss or gain, unprecedented profit or loss. A situation where you suddenly get to have a profit or loss, windfall, loss or profit, दोनों में से कोई भी हो सकता है, loss or gain, but that is unprecedented. वो आपने expect भी नहीं किया था और इससे पहले कभी हुआ भी नहीं. ऐसे किसी भी loss या gain को हम बोलते हैं windfall, loss or gain. Then we have yield. Yield is return or production. So these are the different words that you must go through when you before you solve any economic passage. As we do in every RC10 video, in this video also I am going to solve a particular economic passage with you. So what I suggest you all is that you, when I open the slide of that passage, you people just pause the video and then first solve the passage by your own and then see the solution. That would make you correct where you went wrong, or if you done it correctly, then it would definitely enhance your confidence level. Let's start the passage. So this is the passage. The passage starts saying, Marx, the founder of communism, had predicted the failure of eventual overthrow of capitalism because of what he regarded as its inherent contradiction. He visualized that capitalism would maintain the wages of labor as a low subsistence level while progressively increasing its productivity by the employment of technologically advanced means of production. During the last many decades, the real wages of workers in advanced capitalist countries have gradually and progressively increased. The prediction of Marx have not been borne by the history. So in this passage we have talked about theory of Marx, and he said, or he predicted, or he regarded that in capitalism the wages of labor cannot increase. They will be maintained in low and subsistence level. And he said that and while they would progressively increase the productivity of labor with the help of technology, and the wage would not increase. Now we have question number one. Which of the following supports the statement, the prediction borne out by history? सो दिस लाइन बेसिकली ये वाली जो लाइन है देख इसका सपोर्टिंग स्टेटमेंट द ऑथर इज आस्किंग द स्टेटमेंट इज समथिंग विच सेज द प्रेडिक्शन विच मार्क्स मेड वॉज नॉट सपोर्टेड बाई द हिस्ट्री तो हमको ऐसा ही एविडेंस देना है जो बताए कि इस प्रेडिक्शन को सपोर्ट नहीं किया या फिर ये प्रेडिक्शन जो है उसको अपन प्रूफ नहीं कर सकते हिस्ट्री की हेल्प से तो ऑप्शन से जाते हैं अपन ऑप्शन को एलिमिनेट करेंगे और बेस्ट ऑप्शन में से चूज करने की कोशिश करेंगे ऑप्शन ए कैपिटलिज्म हैज जस्ट सर्वाइव बट नॉट टेकन फ्रॉम रूट्स दिस इज इररिलेवेंट बी द सैलरीज ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज हैव गॉन अप इन एडवांस कंट्रीज अगर हम बोलते हैं हैव गॉन अप दैट मीन्स के एडवांस कंट्रीज में नाउ दिस इज द ऑप्शन विच विज ल्योर यू आपको लगेगा कि यही आंसर होना चाहिए बट देयर इज अ ट्रिक इन दिस क्वेश्चन दे हैव सेड गॉन अप इन एडवांस कंट्रीज बट दे हैव नॉट सेड दैट दीज एडवांस कंट्रीज आर कैपिटलिस्ट और नॉट सो बहुत क्लियरली ऐसा लग रहा है ये ऑप्शन सही होगा बट एडवांस कंट्रीज लिखा हुआ है कैपिटलिस्ट नहीं लिखा हुआ है तो ये भी आपका आंसर नहीं होगा सी टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट हैज नॉट टेकन प्लेस इन कैपिटलिस्ट कंट्रीज में कैपिटलिस्ट टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट नहीं हुआ है इन द अबव पैसेज द ऑथर हैज स्टेटेड दैट टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट वुड रिप्लेस द वेजेस सो दिस इज कम्प्लीट कॉन्ट्रोडिक्शन ठीक ये कॉन्ट्रोडिक्शन हो जाएगा और यही आपका आंसर भी होगा तो डी पे आते हैं अपन द सैलरी ऑफ ऑल द एम्प्लॉइज हैव गॉन डाउन इन ऑल द कंट्रीज ठीक इन ऑल द कंट्रीज बोल देने से ठीक फिर वापस से ये हमारे जो पर्टिकुलर कैपिटलिस्ट कंट्रीज के लिए हमको जो बोलना था वो नहीं रहेगा देन वी हैव देयर इज नो इंक्रीज इन प्रोडक्टिविटी ऑफ वर्कर्स ठीक अब प्रोडक्टिविटी ऑफ वर्कर्स में कोई इंक्रीज नहीं हुआ है ठीक है तो आपके पास दो ऑप्शन है यू हैव ऑप्शन सी और यू हैव ऑप्शन ई इन दोनों में से कोई एक आपको चूज करना पड़ेगा नाउ इन ऑप्शन सी दिस इज स्पेसिफिकली अबाउट कैपिटलिस्ट कंट्रीज ठीक सो मोर अप्रोप्रिएटली वी नीड टू आंसर सी तो सी आपका आंसर होगा क्वेश्चन नंबर वन का लेट्स कम टू क्वेश्चन नंबर टू विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वर्ड इज मोस्ट नियरली द सेम इन द मीनिंग टू वर्ड रिगार्डेड रिगार्डेड कहाँ पे है रिगार्डेड यहाँ पे है सो लेट्स रीड इट The founder of communism had predicted the failure and eventual overthrow of capitalism because of what he regarded as its inherent contradiction. So, respected, no, valued, no, related, no, thought, maybe the answer. क्योंकि हमको यहाँ से क्या समझ में आ रहा है? Because of what he thought as its inherent contradiction. So, estimated again, no. ठीक है सो अगेन यहाँ पे जो क्वेश्चन है आपका क्वेश्चन नंबर टू का आंसर होगा ठीक आई होप दैट यू सॉल्व द पैसेज विथ मी और यू सॉल्व बाय योरसेल्फ एंड देन यू करेक्ट सी द करेक्ट ऑप्शंस एंड देन चेक वेयर यू वेंट रॉन्ग एंड इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट एंड इफ यू फील लाइक देयर इज मोर सच पैसेजेस यू रिक्वायर यू कैन जस्ट कमेंट ऑन द कमेंट सेक्शन एंड इफ यू फील लाइक देयर इज सर्टेन अदर टाइप ऑफ पैसेज दैट यू वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस इन दिस पर्टिकुलर प्लेटफॉर्म यू कैन कमेंट डेफिनेटली आई वुड ट्राई टू क्रिएट दैट टाइप ऑफ वीडियो सो दैट आई कैन हेल्प यू इन मैक्सिमम वे सो लेट्स सी वॉट अदर वीडियोज आई विल बी ब्रिंगिंग फॉर यू RC10 में 3 videos we have already done. Now we have technological videos are left, and which is because technology is something which is current, related to current things which are going on. So next video that I would be bringing would be technological. Then we have management, psychology, religion and politics. Slowly every week these different type of contexts are going to come to you. You just have to do what? To avail all these things, you just have to do this. This first thing, it is completely free. Of course, there's nothing that you need to pay. You just have to subscribe to our channel, Percentile Classes, so that whenever I get a new video, you get a notification of it. And then if you want to avail a PDF related to this video, you just have to download our app, Percentile Classes ka app, aapko Play Store se download karna hoga. And then you just have to WhatsApp on this number that you want to avail the PDF. And you'll definitely have those, the access to that PDF. And then we have I just try to make it as useful as I can. I hope that this help you and motivates you and show you the way in which you can improve your reading comprehension, score more marks in reading comprehension. And last thing that I would like to say is that this video is brought to you by Percentile Classes, and the contact details are this. We are Bhopal based coaching class. This is our address, and you can also find the video you are watching is from our YouTube channel, which is Percentile Classes. If you have not subscribed it, guys, please go and subscribe it, like it, and if you feel that there are other friends of yours, those who may be needing this type of video, share it so that many number of and number of students can be benefited with these with our efforts. And if there's any particular demand and any particular help that I can make, please comment on it. I will definitely bring that type of video to you. And guys, best of luck. All the exams like CAT ke liye, these video series is the best for CAT, because I guess I'm trying to complete it by CAT. Main koshish kar rahi hu ki CAT tak ye pura complete ho jaye. Dekhiye, mera aim hai. And then there are other exams as well. January mein CMAT hoga, CLAT hai. In all these exams, reading comprehension is a very scoring part. So I just, the aim is that you score more and more marks in reading comprehension. The fear to attempt reading comprehension should be completely deleted. You should feel confident and effortlessly good in your reading comprehension. So guys, best of luck. Mrs. Priyanka Sisodia.